Welcome back, everyone, to Pontus Fathom Hobbies. This is Season 4, Episode 4 of Time of Legends, Joan of Arc. We are jumping into Round 4. We had a very eventful Round 3. We were able to get two citizens into the church in the earlier round. Both of the... a power token was played so that the English could perform a... Power token was played so that the French could perform an additional charge in addition to their activation tokens. And we had some conflict. Cart is moving forward toward its destination here. And one rule I failed to notice is for each of the citizens that come through, a power token can be gained here. So we get for each of the civilians, they can get these tokens, intrigue tokens, not power tokens, intrigue tokens. So the French have two and the English have two. Let's jump into round four. Quick shout out to Pontus Fathom Press. As you guys know, we're not monetized on the channel. These games are all mine. It's not like a sponsorship of any sort, just a love of the board game. But we do have a sister channel, Pontus Fathom. Disclosure from the Necronomicon Fragments, Volumes 1, 2, and 3, Necromancy of Nyarlathotep, The Hermeticism of Hastur, and The Alchemy of Azathoth, available at the bookstore link. Check out our Patreon, check out our blogs below, and like and subscribe here. Growing to 1,000 users with your guys' help, so every little bit counts. Appreciate the patronage. So let's jump into round four. We will grab our activation tokens. We haven't either played the French have an additional charge token, and we both have an interrupt token. Maybe we're saving those for a later round. We have 8 rounds. We're halfway at the halfway point in this round, and by the end of this round, so I feel that the English are already making some advancements. Let's see how this turns out. We will also play our three. So we are able to get another activation if we want. Convert activations into tokens. We do have to have the Black Prince take another experience point. So I think what we'll do is we'll gain 2 cards. And then we discard one of the cards. So we'll gain another intrigue token. And English player has ambush or fanaticism. So we can do an ambush for 3 power tokens. That might be the card to do. We'll play an ambush and we can return this one to the deck. And let's have our French also do the same. So they'll grab 2 of these, they'll grab an intrigue token, and we get treaty or first aid. So we can, tenacity, let's take this tenacity one, and we'll discard this healing one. So that'll get us started. Let's jump into the setup too. So we also have our turn, so we can activate for our French user. We will activate again this cavalry, and let's make use of activating this group as well. I believe we have another play that we can do that says, all activated cavalry can act as a charge if I pay that one token again. So we can pay another power token for here, intrigue token. And let's go ahead and go forward with that. So we have activated And since this one doesn't, we can use the power token to activate this charge, we can activate this as well. So we will move, let's move these crossbowmen again, one more round in. We will have the cavalry move the two spaces to attack directly here. So it's come to pass, cavalry versus cavalry in a charge. So let's go ahead and we'll also have these bowmen and halberdiers attack. So let's go through the rounds of it. The bowmen first, they can attack using the two. That's two with the defense of being here. And we have an injury here of these pikemen. Put them here. Next up is we can actually have these halberdiers or almogavars. They are the Volgier. They will only roll the single die, but again, it's defending versus the English Earl of Suffolk. Earl of Suffolk is here, and he gets the defense of two whites. So it's a white versus two whites, and he blocks it. So there is no activity. So he is victorious. We also, because this is activated, am I able to move those peasants on the turn? I can use an activation. No, only the ring the bell does that. Okay, so that's fine. Let's go to the charging cavalry. So we'll start out with mounted knights, two red versus mounted knights, a black. So we can do it, let's do two and two. So we get an attack blocked and two attacks, so we can move one of these. One attack goes through, mounted knights. And there's the last attack from the last mounted knight with the defense and blocked. And then finally we'll have the black knight riding with two red and a yellow. He will be attacking against our mounted Black Knight. So it's our Black Knight will be fighting against Omri of Caron. So he has a sword attack. Black Knight gets a black defense. So his attack is blocked. So luckily for Black Knight, he blocks the defense, and the French are not able to take him, but they did move one of the English mounted knights disrupted. So let's go to clean up this round, and we can go over to the English player. English player again. If the wagon is controlled by the English player, the wagon and all units in this area can move one area for two. So let's have him play two of this. Let me just see if the action cards, do I play with the, the cost on the card is paid in which tokens, exchange points or intrigue points? I think they're played in intrigue points. Trigger and intrigue. So we gain intrigue tokens. So he gained the two. Oh, so yeah. So basically it's not power tokens, it's intrigue tokens. We gained two of them from that last attack. So they're able to play the intrigue here. Instead of, I'll get the intrigue tokens from the box, but just put one virtually here for now. And they can, again, move the cart. So this all can move into this space. Again. So one initial action done. Activations, again, we'll have the Mounted Knight activate. We'll also have these archers activate. Let's have these archers here activate as well. Right, so first up we can have, since we only have the two activations, that's all we can do. So let's do the lobby for the bowman. So that will be three. So one, let's just do the four dice like this. They get two, and then we can roll, and we get a block and a push. So these guys get pushed back, let's say. And then that's for the first two. There's a third bowman here that can go. And again, we have another bowman is injured. So they're injured back. So we can put these peasants here. Let's just put this back on the board for now. And then finally, the cavalry can attack again. So this mounted cavalry, they get to do two. And our mounted cavalry get one, so we can do two and two. And then again, we'll have the Black Knight attacking as well. So basically blocking everything. But the mounted Black Knight, he will attack against mounted Black Knight. Mounted Black Prince will attack against Ulmeri, who has a two black defense. So mounted Black Prince, shield and injured, shield, shield, push, gets the shield, and injured is blocked. So again, skirmish happens, no damage. So we can clean this up. And I think that's going to do it for the round. So, yeah, so we'll move the indicator up to round five. We still have this ambush card ready to play, but the cart is definitely getting closer. So we're really going to have to double down on our attack here. I think maybe move these crossbowmen to try to take the cart. So we'll see you in the next turn. It'll be turn number five. Thanks for watching. And really looking forward to keeping this going. I think that the Black Prince's men are really pushing a race here, and we need to enable some of these archers to put more pressure on this. So maybe moving those forward might be the way to go, or an interrupt order. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next turn. Bye.